Hi, this is Carl the Landscape Guy. Today we're taking a closer look on how to install this X-22 TOPCON system. It is a 2D system which allows us to excavate more accurately. These little yellow boxes here are sensors that have to be attached to the excavator. Each has its own specific position. You only have to charge them once a week of operation. This box here comes with everything you need for it. The six sensors are labeled so you know where they go on the machine. This one here goes to the back next to the cabin. And with these we'll go from front to back. It doesn't matter which way around you put the sensors into the brackets, it works either way. You just have to make sure you slide them all the way in and that they're secured so they don't get lost while working. First, we install the one for the tilt. Then this one is the bucket one. Now we have two for the boom, boom one and two, from front to back. And the last one is the compass on the top of the machine. This kit comes with a heavy-duty suction cup to attach the display unit inside. Now the power cord needs to be connected to the onboard power outlet. Now the power button is down here. This is the start screen, and now I have to go through the setup before I can start working with it. Right now it is set to German, but you can change the language to English in the settings. First we have to choose the right bucket that is already installed. So I select the right one and go back with the arrow. Here I choose the excavator I'm using this kit with, because you have the option to use this kit in different excavators. Now after putting in the main information, I click on Start Digging. But before we can do that, I need to tell the system the measurements that we're using. It tells me to put the bucket teeth on the point that the surveyor gave me. So let's say this is the point. Now the machine tells me to raise my tooth-tip by 2 meters, which is displayed in numerical values on the monitor. We click OK for now, but if you want to be precise, you can check with a measuring stick if it's exactly 2 meters. Now he wants me to extend the boom all the way. Now he wants me to move the boom and the stick to get back to my home point without using the bucket. If I lift that up now, I'll create such a triangle here. The monitor displays the movements of the boom simultaneously. So now I'm back on my measuring point from before, and I say next. Retract the bucket completely and press continue. This way the system adjusts the digging curve. Now again I have to go back to my measuring point with the bucket teeth. Now the adjusting is finished and it's ready for use. Next, I have to tell it what kind of work I want to do by creating a new work. Do I want to excavate a profile, a level, or kinks? Let's say I want to dig a ditch. It displays again the chosen setup, the mode, the control, the excavator type, and the bucket type. Also, my type of reference is displayed here. Besides a given point by a surveyor, it could also be a laser, for example, that you can use this set with. Now it simulates a ditch that is 2 meters deep. I can change my depth here if I want. Let's say I wanted to change it to 1.8 meters. Now I want to have a longitudinal slope in there. I changed that from 2% to 3%. I also want to change the trench width. Now I also want to add an embankment at the top. I choose 45 degrees and save that. Here I see my trench profile. As soon as I start working, the excavator stands exactly at zero altitude, and from there I get it exactly displayed. This is basically how you can set the system up. And this video was created with kind support of Balzer Landscape Construction Company, as well as Schluter Construction Machinery Incorporation. I hope this video was interesting for you. Please feel free to like and subscribe. Thank you very much for watching, and make sure you check out my channel. Have a great day. This is Carl the Landscape Guy.